It is I, LPS Honey, and you know how I did a video recently about these really cool magazine LPS, and in that video I said that I was going to keep them all in their packaging really nicely? Well, today I'm caving and opening them up because I really want to see what they look like out of their packaging, and I also have no room to store them in their packaging, so I kind of have to open them, so let's get started. Okay, yeah. Let's go. This is probably going to be a bonus short video, but they're all still in their box and I'm just going to open them up one by one, starting with our PTSD panda. My man. He's cute. I gotta give it to him. He is adorable. Like, look at him. But those eyes. But he's still cute. I love how the paws in his feet are little hearts as well. And if you'd like to know more information about these hard plastic magazine LPS, you can check out the first video I did on them. I go more into detail in that video, so there'll be a link in the corner and also in the description. Next we have the Cougar. So this is based, I believe, on a G4 mold, so it's not the most like new thing. And the tail's kind of bendy, which is nice. But there she is, very sophisticated looking. I'm honestly so tempted to paint her nose a dark brown. Then we have the man, the myth, the legend, Sonic the Hedgehog, of course. Let me get you out of there. Here he is, ladies and gentlemen, bootleg Sonic. His eyes are so far apart and his nose is wonky, but I still love him. He has a special place in my heart because, boy, I love this color. It looks like a bunch of nerd candies on the back of his head, but I love him. He's adorable in his own special little way. Then we have Austin Golden Pup. Also, some of you guys were telling me that these were based on characters from the show. I've never watched the show, so I have no idea. But a lot of you said that you really like this one, so this one's for you. Here he is, bro. He looks like a full-on bobblehead LPS. Like, he's done so well. He's honestly so pretty, and I love how his ears have this dark kind of goldish color to them that gradients into the regular tan color of his body. Like, this is one of my favorites, hands down. I love him, and I just realized he has freaking eyebrows, which is so cute as well. They really, really did a good job on this one. Me? Complimenting Hasbro? What is this? So this one's Eddie Von Keet. I forgot to add a picture of him in my last video because I said that this was actually already an LPS, which it is, but Eddie, please. The regular version of this LPS is metallic, so I will definitely put the picture up this time. I'm sorry I forgot it last time, but there it is. And a lot of you said he was from the show again, so that's why he has a name. But yeah, here he is. I like him non-metallic like this. I think it's a good look. It looks much more like bird-like, like realistic to birds. But yeah, I really like how he looks. He does look a bit different to the like real metallic one. Even the mold is different. So that's pretty cool. Then we have this long-haired cat, or fluffy cat as they call it. And I speculated that these kind of ones were based off the Fortune Pets because they have a kind of yellow theme on the head, which a lot of the Fortune Pets had. So here she is, very cute. The colors are definitely bold, but it's nice. I really like the orange. I'm not the biggest fan of the purple shade they used, but the orange is really, really pretty. We have this kind of pinkish red cat. This one also does not have a name. And I think this is just kind of like, I don't know, like, you know how G2 had the lying down cats? I think this is the modern version of that, but it's like the sitting cats. I don't know. This one's probably like one of the ones that isn't done as well. It's definitely like noticeable that it's not a bobblehead LPS. It's more like cheaper plastic and it kind of looks not as well painted in certain areas. So this one ain't it. But I still like her. She definitely has an odd charm. I could see myself using her as like a statue. There's also two different bunnies. This is the first one here. It is a pink, I'm going to say Angora bunny. It looks a lot like an Angora bunny, so that's just what we're going with. But here she is. Pretty basic design. I like her. She looks like she has a bit of an attitude, which I'm all about. And yeah, I don't know why with so many of these magazine pets, they made him face sideways. Like, bro, just make it face forward, please. Like, why is that so difficult? Like, this one's facing sideways, this one's facing sideways. It's like, bro, just turn the head straight. Oh my God. This one's also a bit lesser quality, much like the cat I just showed, but it's better quality than the cat, so I like it more. It's very bubblegum looking, and I really like this one. I think they did a good job on the molding, and there's only a bit of paint on it, so there's not a lot I can like criticize there, but the paint that is there is pretty well done. Then we have this long-eared bunny, which is so cute. I really, really like this one. So I'm super happy to be opening this one, because I think I only have maybe like one or two bunnies that have long ears like this, so I really, really like this one. I think it's very well molded and painted and looks like a official bobblehead LPS. The eyes are printed on slightly wonky, don't get me wrong, but overall it's really good, and I love how they put the bow on the hair instead of just like randomly on the head. I thought that was a really good choice. And lastly, we have an older version from Pets in the City, Penny Ling from the old show that they used to make. So this is an older one, older packaging, old logo, everything like that. But I still wanted to get it because I thought it was a really cute design. She's probably my favorite design of like the TV show characters that they made for a while. Just because it's a pretty cute panda and there's not much they could like mess up, whereas some of the other characters didn't have the most like cutest designs in the world. But I think she turned out pretty good. A few chips on the nose and tongue, but nothing major. So there you have it, guys. I ended up caving and opening them all up. I just couldn't resist, and like I said, I didn't have any room for keeping them in their packages. Unfortunately, I'm kind of like short on room in my household, so I kind of had to do it, but I will finish this video off with some close-up shots of them, showing you a bit more detail if any of you are interested. But for now, I will do my outro and just leave you with that. So I hope you enjoyed watching this unboxing of my magazine LPS. Like I said, I will leave you with a kind of like a slideshow, but not really, just like a video showing you close-ups of all the pets so you can see their detail better. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed, and I will see you next time. Bye, guys.